There's nothing like forgiveness. If we take our time and we really sit back and think about it, Jesus died for us. On a cross, he said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." While we were still sinners, the Bible says Christ died for us. While we were sinning against him. Some say, "Well, I wasn't there." Or some say, "Well, I don't believe in that." Well, yeah, you weren't there. I wasn't either. But think about it. We sin every day of our life. And God is just saying, "Come to me." And you see, I heard this story one time, and it was a father and his son, and they were in Africa, in the middle of the desert, and the car broke down, and the father got out the car along with the little boy, and the little boy had a ball. And the son said, "Father, I'm just going to go play over here." The father said, "Alright, son." And so the father started working on the car, and the son was a little ways away from him. The father looked up at the son and said, "Son, I'm really far." He said, "Okay, Dad." So he started working the car again. And then he looked up and he said, "Son, it was even more far away." He said, "Son, don't go that far." He said, "Okay, Dad, I'm just playing, I'm having fun." And he started working the car again. And he looked up this time, he saw the son even more far away. But this time when he looked up, he saw a lion behind the bushes. The father couldn't yell because he knew if you'd have yelled, the lion would have got the kid, and immediately the kid would die. So the father was like, "Son, come here," whispering and trying desperately to get his son to come here. But the son was like, "Dad, you know, we've been in that car all day. I'm tired. I just want to have fun. Let me be, let me be." And the father saw the lion was about to strike, so he ran and he tried to scream out, "Son, come here." And the son saw the lion. And the son was about trying to run to his father. And the lion grabbed the son and he mauled him before the father's eyes. That's a perfect picture to what we see in this day. Where God is that father, we're that kid. And God is saying, "Come here." But we say, "No, it's okay. I'm going to do what I want to do. Let me be. Let me be. I'm having fun." But you don't see. You know, we don't see the lion that's behind us, the devil. We don't see that. God sees us, though. He's saying, "Come here." We say, "No." And when we realize who it is behind us, we try to run to God, but it becomes too late. So I urge you before it is too late, because one day we will see God. He will come down. Jesus will come down on the clouds, and it will be too late at that point in time. Some of you say, "Well, I want Jesus. I want him now." And if you do, all you have to do is repeat after me. You say, "Jesus, I give you my life. I give you all of me. Save me. I know that you died for me. I know that you rose again. Forgive me, Lord. I repent of my sins. I turn away from them. In Jesus' name, amen." And at that moment, not tomorrow, not next year, not next week, at that moment, you will be saved. The scripture says, "For all who call on the name of the Lord shall be saved." You will be saved. And you will have a home in heaven awaiting you. All you have to do is trust in the Lord God and trust in his son, and you will see heaven. I love you all, and God bless.